Welcome to K4Tech Systems channel and thank you very much for watching this video. Hello friends, I am here with you to introduce you a current and voltage protector device. Its brand name is a SINOTIMER. You might have seen other videos of similar product without a detailed description. But here you must feel that you know everything when you finish watching this video. This video is about a protector device used to protect electrical equipment. This is a smart device that performs over voltage or under voltage protection and over current protection instantly in the event of over voltage or under voltage and over current faults. And it protects the electrical equipment being burned out or damaged when power returns to normal state and protector can automatically restore power. Now we will see how this device is seen while working after installation. You can see the following display in front of the panel. Voltage and current display. It works as a voltmeter and ammeter by displaying voltage and current measurement. Voltage indicator light. Voltage indicator light and current indicator light. The voltage indicator light flashes quickly in case of over voltage, slowly in case of under voltage, and it is constantly on, as you can see now, in case of normal voltage. You can see in the video that it is constantly on. Current indicator light, it flashes in case of over current and it constantly on when current is normal, which you can see in this video. This protector has a self-resetting function, which is important. After this protector performs disconnection due to voltage or current fault, it will restore connection after fault recovery time. So load appliance shall be removed immediately. After the overcurrent exceeds 5 times within the scheduled time, protector will not restore power supply automatically. In this case, we need to press the set button manually to unlock power supply. It is important to remember that this device does not protect from short circuit. We should use miniature circuit breaker for that.
See the technical parameters printed on the container box.
Power consumption is maximum 2 watt.
Electrical and mechanical lifespan greater than or equal to 4000 times. To work with this device, we need to understand how to modify settings, how to save modifications and how to do reset. Now we will see how to modify settings. Now press and hold this settings button for 3 seconds to enter setting mode. Now we have entered into setting mode. Now it is P01. Press again if you can change by up button or down button to decrease voltage or increase voltage. Now press the set button again to go to P02. If you want to change, you can change P down up arrow or down arrow here. Now you can go to set button, press again P03, now P04, P06, now P07, you can press down or up, down or up arrow to modify. Now press 08, now P09, P010, P011, P012, now again pressing will reach to end. Now if you press set again, it will be saved. Now we have saved whatever we changed it.
Now we will discuss about P01 over voltage value. This is the overvoltage value for disconnecting power supply. When voltage rises beyond this value, the protector will disconnect power supply. Range we can set is from 221 volt to 300 volt. Then we can set off. Off indicates that the overvoltage protection function is off. Default overvoltage value is 280 volt. You can see a few plugs in the video which says about voltage range. Almost plugs are below 250 volt. So we will change this value to 260 volt from default 280 volt. Next is P02, overvoltage recovery value. After power supply is disconnected due to overvoltage, when voltage restores and reaches to the recovery voltage value we set here or a below voltage, then this device restores power supply. Range is off. Then 220 volt to 299 volt. When the overvoltage protection setting is off, overvoltage recovery value will also be turned to off. 250 is the default overvoltage recovery value. We do not change this value. Next is P03, overvoltage actuation time value. It is the overvoltage actuation time or response time for action when overvoltage occurs. Modification range is from 0.1 to 10 seconds and default value is 0.1 second and that one is recommended. Now P04, undervoltage value. Like overvoltage, undervoltage may also damage electrical equipments. If voltage goes under the voltage level we set here, this protector device will disconnect power supply and protect electrical equipments. Range we can set is off, then 150 volt to 219 volt. Off indicates that the undervoltage protection function is off. Default undervoltage value is 160 volt. P05, undervoltage recovery value. When undervoltage fault occurs, protector will disconnect the power supply. In the process of recovery to the normal voltage, when voltage restores to the voltage recovery value we configure here, then power supply will be restored. Range is from off, then 151 volt to 220 volt. 180 volt is the default undervoltage recovery value. When undervoltage value is off, undervoltage recovery value will also be turned to off. P06, undervoltage actuation time value. It is the undervoltage action time or response time for action when undervoltage occurs. It means when undervoltage occurs, there is a little time before the protector cut off power supply. Modification range is 0.1 to 10 seconds. Default value is 0.1 second and it is recommended to be less than or equal to 0.3 seconds. Next is P07, overcurrent value. With this protector, we can set overcurrent value in a range from 1 ampere to 80 ampere. If the ampere requirement of electrical equipments goes above the set value, power supply will be cut off. Default overcurrent protection value is 80 ampere. For example, when we set 3 ampere as overcurrent value, we can load one or more devices. Total ampere requirement of them should be below 3 ampere. That is, load should be below 690 watt power if voltage is 230 volt. P08, overcurrent actuation time. Overcurrent actuation time or response time is the time the protector takes for a disconnection after overcurrent occurred. It is 5 seconds by default. It ranges from 1 to 512 seconds. Next program is P09, fault recovery time value. When a fault occurs, in order to recover this fault, we need to elapse some time before restores power supply. This is to allow removing the issues that caused the fault. It is called fault recovery time value. Modification range is 2 to 512 seconds. Default time for fault recovery is 60 seconds. P10. Default delay time for power on. When the protector receives power, it will power on after this default delay time. We can modify delay time value for power on from 2 to 512 seconds. Default is 2 seconds. Next is P11, Reset Selection Mode. There are two reset selection modes for power restore, AU and HA. AU is automatic, which is default for power restore. HA is manual reset. When manual reset mode HA is selected, protector will not supply power automatically after it is powered on. Similarly, when the line voltage fault occurs, the protector will not restore the power supply even after the line fault is removed. It is necessary to manually press the set button for power restoration. Next is P12. P12 displays the last fault code occurred. Press the up button to query the last 5 faults. There are 3 fault codes, UL, UH and IH. UL means under voltage, UH means over voltage and IH means over current. First digit in the code indicates order of occurrence of a fault. For example, 1 UL, it means the last fault is under voltage. 2 UH, second last fault code was over voltage. 3 IH means third previous fault code occurred was over current. Similarly, you can predict fault codes. In the video, total 4 faults occurred. 1 IH means last fault is over current, 2 IH means second fault was over current, 3 IH means last third fault was over current, 4 IH means fourth fault was over current, 5 means no fifth fault occurred. So it shows only occurrence number. Last program is P13. Pressing set button again while displaying P12 will move to P13 and below displays end, meaning setting is completed. Pressing end will save the data, exit the setting state and display the present voltage and the current value of the line. For just an example, we decide to protect devices if current increases above 3 ampere. In other words, we can say we don't allow any devices which require power consumption above 690 watt. So total ampere requirement of these devices should be below or equal to 3 ampere. In this situation, when we operate an iron instrument which requires 1000 watt, this protector should cut off power supply when switched on. Let us see if it works or not. Now we are going to set this device for current to 3 ampere, just 3 ampere. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 is a, we will change this one. Now we are going to change program 7, which is current control. Now we will change it to 3 ampere. Now we are going to save. Set and we'll move to program 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. Now end. Now we have saved. We have installed the protector between inverter and load. Inverter has a steady voltage of 230 volt. We use the idea that when we modify our voltage value of protector to 220 volt, then 230 volt of inverter becomes our voltage for protector device. Now let us reduce P01 value to 220 volt. We modified and we saved it. Then our voltage fault occurred and switch light turned to off. But note that fault recovery time remains in 60 seconds and does not go down because our voltage fault still exists. So let us see what happens when we modify our voltage value of protector to restore to 240 volt. We are doing this change and then go to P13 to save it. See now, fault recovery time is going down from 60 seconds to 1 second. Yes. Now the light indicating inverter output line has Now the light indicating inverter output line has been turned on, meaning that electricity restored when fault state is removed. Yes, now our voltage protection function is working very well. Now let me wind up this video. I have tried to explain 13 settings and how to modify them and save to meet your requirement. We have tested our current and our voltage and correctly explained and showed you how the devices respond to each such event. I hope you know you can configure this device very easily if you remember the settings or refer the video. If you have any doubts or suggestions, I'm happy to read and reply to them. If you like this video, please give your valuable likes, comment and share. Also subscribe my channel and press bell icon to support me to have similar videos with you. Thank you for your support and time.